It's Sunday Morning on CBS. Here again is Jane Pauley.
It's no secret that the Brothers Osborne are nominated for Best Duo at tonight's Academy of Country Music Awards here on CBS. But what had been a secret for one of them is now out in the open. Here's Anthony Mason.
Deal, Maryland is a blue-collar fishing town along the Chesapeake Bay.
If we hadn't hit the brakes, we'd have no idea. Paradise was hiding right here, dipping our toes in the water.
A paradise that's also hometown to one of country music's hottest duos, Brothers Osborne.
It's a little town. As people like to say, there's more boats than people here. Yeah. This is the Chesapeake Bay.
TJ Osborne and his older brother, John, used to catch crabs off this pier.
5 to 7 days a week, we would be in this water, running around, swimming, playing.
Where did your love of music come from?
When we first started wanting to learn how to play and sing, it was really so we could just join in with the family.
Their parents put them in music classes early.
And surprisingly, had you heard us play violin at that age, you'd think, yeah, music was never going to happen for these kids. They are terrible.
They practiced in a shed out back of their house.
Does this look pretty much the same, or has it changed?
It looks way different. Yeah. This wasn't here.
It looks a lot nicer.
Yeah. There's no beer cans laying around anywhere.
When their dad, Big John Osborne, a plumber and part-time songwriter, formed a band called Deuce and a Quarter, the brothers joined, John on guitar and TJ on bass. Some of their earliest gigs were at the Happy Harbor Bar in Deal. That's when Big John saw something in his boys.
I kind of noticed these guys are pretty good, and I tried not to be the dad. But I could see it.
The brothers both went off to Nashville, John first to make his name as a guitar player. TJ followed, starting out as a solo act. Sometimes he'd book his brother to play behind him.
People kept mentioning the two of you guys together is something special, yeah. Which basically equated to you singing by yourself is not as interesting.
And an hour and a half of guitar solos, surprisingly, are also not very interesting.
In 2012, as Brothers Osborne, they landed a recording deal.
We pulled in the driveway, and I just started crying. Finally, all of the work that we have put in over the years, and all of the setbacks, and all the odd jobs, and all the weird gigs I've played, finally is starting to pay off. I got my hands up,
I need an alibi. Behind hits like It Ain't My Fault, their debut album, Pawn Shop, climbed to number 3 on the country charts.
The trajectory, if you looked at it on the graph, there's no big spikes. It's just a slow and steady rise.
But in 2019, as the brothers were making their latest album, Skeletons, John, who'd battled anxiety since childhood, hit a crisis point.
I remember calling our manager at the time, and I told him, I can't go in the studio. I don't know what's wrong with me. I don't know why. I'm not happy. I'm depressed. My anxiety is through the roof. I can't sleep. My ears are ringing.
Were you worried about him in the middle of all this?
Oh, big time. I could just look at him and tell he did not want to be there. And that's when I was like, wow, we need to go home now. We ended up canceling some dates.
And with a lot of therapy, a lot of self-help, a lot of love from my friends and family, I was able to kind of get to a better place so we can finish the album. But going into this record, I considered quitting music.
Really?
Which is something I never in my life thought I would want to do.
The pandemic gave the brothers a moment to step back. That's when TJ realized he finally had to be open about his sexuality.
I remember sitting down and I was like, I have to come out. Like, I have to do this.
This February, in a Time magazine article, TJ came out as gay. A fact he'd shared with his brother just before they signed their record deal.
What did you say when he told you?
I just said, I know, and then I just started crying a lot, which I'm learning in this segment that I do cry a lot.
I know, we're crying.
I'm a total softie.
Why were you crying?
I was just happy for him. I knew how much it meant to him to feel close enough and vulnerable enough to say that.
There are not a lot of openly gay artists in the country music scene. Were you worried at all about how this would be taken?
I guess I was. And I mean, and I was worried all the way up until the day I did it. But I think once I finally like made the decision I was going to, I felt very sure in that. But it's just really the fear of the unknown. Do we lose fans? Also, what I didn't know was how positive it would be. I did not know that.
You got a lot of support.
Incredible amounts of support. And there's been some people saying some off-color things to me, but it was a lot less than I expected.
When TJ made his announcement in February, were you guys nervous at all about that?
It was quite emotional and a very special day in the Osborne household.
Sister Natalie and their parents, John and his ex-wife, Tricia, supported TJ fully.
The main thing in life is character.
Yes.
No matter what you do, who you are, and TJ's character is flawless.
We were so happy. It was one of the best days of my life, I can tell you. You need to paddle on the left, paddle
on the right, because we're all in the same damn boat. It's a turning point, not only for Brothers Osborne, but for Nashville.
What's your sense of where things are in country music right now?
I've never in my life been more proud to be a part of country music than I am today.
Absolutely, yeah. Country, for the longest time, it was a pretty narrow lane of what it needed to sound like, what it needed to look like, and that's slowly starting to change.
This genre is beautiful and amazing, and the songwriting and the performing is incredible, and it's only going to get better the more people we allow to do it.